Dr. Sammy Gibson with Eastwood Animal Clinic. Today, one of the things we're going to talk about is puppy training, some just the basics. There's a lot of ways to do it. There's a lot of books. Feel free, sure, you can always reference them. Just make sure you pick a good source. Some veterinarians are very comfortable with it, some not so much, and everything in between. So what I mainly want to talk to you about is when you get one of these puppies after they've been updated with their shots and all that good stuff, you want to get them used to being handled and messed with. Some patients, when you do a nail trim, they scream bloody murder, they think the world is ending. You need to touch them when they're a puppy and positively reinforce them. So what I mean by that is when you have your puppy, take the nails, pinch the nails. They don't like the pressure a lot of times with the nail trim. And if you can get them used to the pressure with the nail trims, that's wonderful. It'll make your life easier than sometimes a lot of owners can do it themselves at home. And, you know, that can save you a little bit of money there. And that's always great for everybody. Get them used to everything. Nothing is special and private. Touch all of it. Yes, including the private part areas. You need to clean them. Keep them clean, especially on the females, on the males. Touch the areas. Make sure they're good. The reason is if they ever get traumatized or you have to medicate something on there, you can do what the veterinarian's asking you to do and your patient will allow you to do it and you can follow, send home instructions and kind of treat the area that needs to be treated. But the big areas, mess with the ears. Some dogs are terrified of their ears being handled and messed with. Open their mouth, stick your finger in there, close it, do different things. That's a great one. Toes, feet are another big one. Tails. Another one is restraint. A lot of patients are good with the other things, but they've never actually been held, and they've always been allowed to do whatever they want, whenever they want, how they want. Well, when we're trying to do our doctor exams and the technicians are trying to help us out, whether it's for a nail trim, get a look at a laceration from a dogfight or car, whatever, we want to be able to restrain them to keep the patient safe, the staff safe, and so that we can really get in there and look. And sometimes these things hurt and they're just reacting because it hurts and they're saying, ow, and stop. We just go from there. So get them used to being handled. One of the best ways is you want to get a firm, good little hug on them. Usually we'll have the neck right in the shoulder area and hold them firm up here. Don't let them go if they're struggling. If they get out when they're a puppy, they're going to think the more they fight, bite, scratch, make noise, the faster they're gonna get what they want and get out. They are like little children. You've got to train them and get them used to what is acceptable and what is not acceptable. So just get them used to being held, and then you can even have a buddy help you out and hold them and then give them a lick of peanut butter, give them a dog treat, do the positive reinforcement. Side tip, a lot of healthy treats for these guys, carrots, green beans, celery, and then just use your dog food or something like that. Careful if you're giving them a lot of treats. They're usually very high in calories, and that leads to some other issues. So, hope that's a little helpful tip for you guys. Hope that helps you out a little bit. Let us know, and hope you're enjoying it. We'll see y'all next time.